Hey guys, welcome to the Mini Major Daily presented by OGIO Powersports. I'm Don Maeda and I am joined by my co-host Roger Larson of 7MX, and today we have practice going on. People pulled in yesterday to Silver Dollar MX, and we're joined by Matt Walker, our what would you be here, the promoter, the co-promoter?
I don't know. Right now I'm just a water truck.
There you go. Helping you out.
I'm a water truck driver today, but Aaron does a good job. I promote the racing, making sure the track works good. I guess I'm the track promoter, and Aaron handles all the stuff on the other side as far as making sure everybody signs up and just does all the other end of the racing stuff that it takes to make it all go around and work right.
Did you see that water truck? He's got a bad water truck.
He's got a good water truck.
Yeah, it's funny. Let me tell you the story real quick. And you said I was going to talk forever. I'm not talking forever, but look. So Aaron, right? We do this deal, and give you guys some ins and outs real quick. So Aaron sends me this proposal that we agreed on everything, and in the proposal email, it's got this list of stuff that you need, and he's like, "Oh, you need 3 water trucks." I'm like, three water trucks? Like, I'm not getting 3 water trucks for this race. He's like, "Oh, you have to. That's what we do in California." I'm like, "Bro, my one water truck is 3 water."
Yeah, but in his defense, the second water truck wasn't here 5 minutes and got a flat tire. So
it did.
You need 2 water trucks.
So actually, we ended up getting 3, but the point was, it's a big water truck. It's an army truck, you know.
It's bad.
You gotta have. That's the deal. You gotta have the best of the best if you're gonna.
Everything in Georgia.
That's right. The best gear. Yeah.
The best Napa right down the street.
That Napa doesn't get any better.
I had the best breakfast in Georgia. Matt brought it to my door this morning.
But you didn't even eat it. This guy doesn't eat red meat, so he gave it
to
Kyle.
He only eats chicken fingers.
Is that what it is?
That's not true.
Okay, so Mini Major East. This is the inaugural event. Actually, it was Roger Larson's idea. So, you know, we've had the Mini Major West for 5 years now. It's grown exponentially every year. Our Mini Major West this past October had 1,100 entries at it. So, biggest year yet. How did you get the idea? What inspired you?
Loretta's this year. I think Matt's a big fan of the PW class, and so is Malcolm. And just, it seemed like every time that those motos were up, we were all kind of down by the start gate. And he just knows every little kid coming up. He knows all the parents, and he's always kind of telling me, "Hey, watch out for this kid, or this kid's, you know, good." So I think just with his ties and his track, and you know, us wanting to come back east, it was just a perfect fit. Mm-hmm. So I came to him first at Loretta's, and then I left and went and called you and Donnie Wilson, and like here we are, 6 months later.
Yeah.
No, not even 6 months. Didn't we plan this in like 3?
Technically. I guess when it all really August, came together was just September, a few months ago. So it moved pretty quick, but it's cool to see it all come together.
Okay, so this facility, it's my first time here. I pulled in and it's amazing. Big, long track, pretty amazing dirt. Matt, tell us a little bit about Silver Dollar MX.
So Silver Dollar MX is one of the oldest tracks in Georgia. And it's right in the middle of the state, and so that's what makes it such a good draw. And it's a track that I grew up racing on as an amateur, being from Georgia. And it's a track that I took over a few years ago. And the first thing that we did was this track has been around again since the mid '90s, but it was kind of stuck in that two-stroke era of, you know, fast back and forth, and just it was a two-stroke track. And you know, tracks racing has evolved a lot since in the mid '90s, and so we had to build this track. We had to build this track to this new age of racing, right? And mm-hmm. So I wanted something big and flowy and open, and I wanted to utilize the dirt and just make sure we purposely put obstacles where we did, and to make it special so everybody can see. And when you pull in this racetrack, you know, you look at it and you're like, "Oh, Jesus, man, look at this. You know, I get to I get to race on this track. You know, mm-hmm. that's the kind of vibe we wanted to put, and so that's what we did. And so again, this is my second year running it here, and the turnout has been amazing. In this race, you know, that's why I wanted to do this race, because I knew it was gonna, you know, people are gonna be stoked on it. You guys are gonna be stoked on it because you guys, you've never really been to Georgia. No mm-hmm. one's ever really been here. You know, well, it's the state.
You can't ride this track every. It's not open.
No, exactly. Yeah, we don't open it very often. And people say, why don't you open it all the time? You know, I'm like. It's like eating your favorite restaurant. If you eat your favorite restaurant every day, is it going to be your favorite restaurant? No, it's not. It's gonna, you're just kind of, well, that's okay. I'll catch it next time, right? I'll catch it next weekend. Tracks that are open every weekend, they don't make it, right?
Yeah.
Or they do in California. They don't here.
Mm.
So we open every four-ish months, and when we open these gates, like I tell people, we put on a show.
And people come.
And people come. And, and then that's just how we do it, you know? But we're consistent. The track has to be perfect. You know, I bring all my equipment. I bring all the best workers, all the best help, and we make sure this thing is perfect. So every time you come out here, it's good.
Okay, last question, Matt. The women's class or the girls' classes,
yeah.
Dude, there's a lot of girls here. And
yeah.
It's because you arranged something special.
Well, so... When we did our race back in May, first race back after COVID, the girls, there were, you know, we didn't have a class for them, and I felt bad, and so I made a vow then. I said, listen, I'm going to do something special for these girls, and it was going to be in November, and this race is in November, and it just worked perfect to do it here, but I wanted to do, you know, money. They've never, and they may not ever have a chance to race for money and feel rewarded for their efforts mm-hmm. and like guys do. You know, like if you're a 12-year-old kid right now, you at like a kid somebody here, you know, at some point when they get 16 or 17, they can probably graduate to A class at some level and maybe make a little bit of money riding A class locally.
Mm-hmm.
A girl, some do, but not a lot have that opportunity to you know, feel some monetary gain from racing. So I wanted to do that, you know, and I put some feelers out, and people just...
It's a pretty big purse, isn't it?
Yeah, it's, $4,000 now? Maybe $4,500? Somebody said he's going to give me $500, so maybe $4,500 that we're going to split.
Between the two girls' classes?
Between the juniors and the
wow.
seniors. And, but you can't double up on those classes, Swap. You can't,
okay.
like,
one
double,
or the other.
Double dip. Yeah, you either go in one or the other. And I hate calling it a purse, you know, because you think purse, you think, oh, it's a, you know, like a satchel.
I think purse, I think about women.
Exactly. But I'm saying cash, you know, it's
yeah.
cash money, no Venmo, no,
no
we're giving
Venmo.
Them cash, you know what I mean? I'm not doing PayPal, no Venmo, no check. They're getting cash money, and I want them to feel... you know, included in this sport, you know, no, you know, and that's really what it boils down to is they need to feel as equal as the boys, and we need to embrace it.
Okay, so, and then custom upfits, Todd Ford over there, he's putting at a $300 hole shot award, I
that's
understand,
right.
right?
Yeah, and that just got sprung up too. So people, when you tell them that story of, hey man, you know, there's a need for girls to be in this sport,
mm-hmm.
but if we don't ever have a class for them, how the hell is it ever going to grow? That was what it was brought on me. It's like, hey, Matt, we don't do a class in this series because there ain't no girls.
Yeah.
I'm like, there's girls, but maybe they're just not race. You know, I don't know. But
yeah.
Bottom line is, if you don't ever have classes for them, it will never grow. So we're going to have classes and. And we're going to give them money at this one, and hopefully one day we'll look back on this and say, yeah, you know what, man, we did the first amateur girls money purse, you know?
Purse.
I keep saying, I hate saying that, you know, because it, but whatever, you know, it is what it is.
All righty, cool. Well, hey, practice is well underway, as you can probably hear the bikes behind us, but Mel Walker, thanks for having us out.
Yeah,
and
thank you guys for coming.
Let's find our next guest. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm here with Kaitlyn Lane, and you've driven all the way from Florida. That's quite a way to come for the Mini Major East.
Yeah, that's a good practice for Mini O's.
Yeah. So how did you hear about the race, and what made you want to come to it?
Well, my mom told me about the race, and I came to the race because Matt Walker set up the race, really this race for the girls to race. Mm-hmm. So at that point, I had to go to support it.
Yeah. Okay, so... I understand that Matt Walker has arranged a women's cash prize purse, right? So
yeah.
Is that pretty exciting that you can actually earn some dough?
Yeah, I have a chance.
I
have a pretty good chance. So
okay, so if you win, do you get the money or do you have to hand it over to your mom for expenses?
No, mom said I can keep it.
Okay, so what are you going to buy if you win some money here?
I'll get some new gear sets for Mini O's.
Nice, nice. Okay, so Seven is the presenting sponsor of the Mini Major East. I noticed you're decked out head to toe in Seven. Are you a support rider or do you just like the brand?
No, they don't help me out, but I really like their gear.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you like about it? I mean, do you like the image of it, the fit?
Well, I like it because it fits me better, and the compression shirt because I sweat a lot, and... Like, if you wear any other gear, it's not really tight on your... It's not too tight, but it catches, like, all your sweat.
Uh-huh.
And I feel like you can breathe better in it.
Yeah. You know, girls don't sweat. They glisten. Girls aren't supposed to say that they sweat.
Oh, well, I sweat.
Okay, so you are also racing the Supermini class, I understand, right?
Yeah.
So tell me about racing for you. How did you get involved in motocross and... Why dirt bikes instead of something like gymnastics or... you know, piano?
Well, my dad, he used to run pro, so it was, it's always, like, been in the family. And mom wanted me to play, like, softball, but that was, no.
No softball,
No
huh?
softball.
Right on. So, what is the track like? Have you been here before, or is this your first time? I mean, it looks amazing out there.
This is my second time.
Uh-huh.
The first time was the first race back from COVID.
Okay.
So, I feel way better this time than last time, for
nice.
Sure.
Nice. Okay, so... there's two women's classes, right? There's like a junior and senior?
Yeah.
So you're riding senior, I imagine?
Yeah.
And then also the super mini class. So, like, do you like racing against the guys?
I do, because I feel it makes my confidence go up, too, because I can run with some of the boys. And I always run with the boys because there's really no girls' classes, so you have to run with the boys.
Mm-hmm.
Or you won't learn because you need someone in front of you to learn, or
yeah.
You're not learning anything, so...
Cool. Awesome. Well, I think was it number
33? Yeah.
All right. So we'll keep an eye on the number 33 Husqvarna of Miss Lane here. So good luck and thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
Hey, we're here with our next guest, super mini hero from Southern California, Roger. He's your guy. Why don't you introduce him?
Yeah, he's actually from Canada.
He's Canada.
Yeah.
But he lives in California.
Yep. Yeah.
Well?
Yep.
Noah Viney?
Yeah.
So, what's it like out there here at Silver Dollar MX? I saw you out on the track looking pretty good. I think you led that whole practice.
Yeah, the track's pretty good. It's sandy in some spots, and some of it's hard-packed.
Yeah. How does it compare to tracks in California? Probably nothing like what we have, right? Everything we got is hard-packed.
It actually kind of feels like riding Pala in some places on the track.
Mm-hmm. So, Noah Viney, man, a few words. So, Roger, you've been a sponsor of the Viney family for quite some time. What caught your attention about them?
I actually met him at the, like really met him at Mini Major, maybe, 4 years ago? But it was obviously in at Milestone. Is where I met him and his dad. And he's got an older brother, too, that raced for us. But I think he just joined the, what did he join, Army or Air Force?
The Army.
Yeah.
So, a Canadian joined the U.S. military.
Yeah.
But you guys are moved here full-time then?
Yeah. He gets his citizenship soon.
Okay. So, were you born in Canada and came down here, or were you actually born here?
I was born in Canada. I lived there for 9 years and... We moved here 5 years ago or something.
So they actually bought Ronnie Feist's old house, and then they built a really, really nice Supercross track there. So he's got some Supercross skills.
Yeah, yeah. That's the track that we were at with the Panerite guys, right?
Yeah, yep.
Okay,
that's
the one. So did you guys move to the United States for motocross?
My dad got a job offer, and then we moved here. And I don't know.
But yeah, it was for motocross.
We just went to a lot more races.
It was for motocross.
For motocross.
Yeah.
Okay, so Roger, Noah here, is he the only kid that was at the Mini Major West that's at the East too, or are there some other kids that you know?
That we brought? Yeah, probably. We had a couple other kids lined up, but Adler Cottle broke his collarbone 2 days ago, you know, getting ready for this race. And Zollers is, you know, he kind of, little bit too big for a super mini now, so he's full-time on a big bike. So he's the lone soldier that we brought.
So Noah, you've done several of the Mini Major West, correct? I mean, what do you think of the event? Like, how have they gone for you?
They've gone good. It's pretty good racing. Most of the time there's like three fast kids in my class, and it's fun battling them.
Uh-huh. So who are the guys to look out for this weekend? Who's your main competition?
Drew, if he's racing my class.
Drew Adams.
Drew Adams.
On a Cowie.
Is he the one in answer gear?
Yeah.
Oh, Mr. Oppo Whips. Did you see those out there?
No.
Yeah, he looked pretty good.
But he was good at Cal Classic a couple weeks ago.
Cal Classic?
Yeah.
Cool. So, did you guys drive out here? I was talking to your dad, and he said that he's got a van that he keeps at Ferries with two bikes. So, like, do you have a fleet on the East Coast and on the West Coast?
What do you mean?
Or did you guys fly here and grab your
your
bikes that you keep on?
We left a box van here. It had an 85, and then we just picked up that Super Mini at Conrad's.
Okay. So is that Super Mini built for you, or was it somebody else's bike that you're racing?
Mine.
Yeah. What was it like watching somebody else race your bikes at Mini Major West? So didn't Zollers rode your bike, right?
Yeah.
He used his bike and his mechanic.
Yeah. Okay, so you missed Mini Major West because you had an interesting injury. Can you tell us about it?
At Loretta's, I collided with someone midair, and I don't really remember after that, but his pipe was burning my stomach, and I got a third degree burn from that.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I had some problems with my back when I got back.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I didn't race that race.
So did a third degree burn is super serious. Did you have to get a skin graft or anything?
No, but now it just takes longer because I didn't do that.
Oh, really? It was an option though, and you passed on it.
Yeah.
Ah. So when the bike was on you, burn you, were you? Did you realize it was burning you? You're like screaming to get it off, or was it like?
I don't think I was awake. I just don't remember.
Oh, wow, I got knocked out and burned. That's terrible. Eesh. Well, are you all healed up from that now? Is this going to affect you at all here this weekend, or are you all good to go?
No, it's not going to affect me, but I still have the burn.
Yeah.
It's probably like 2 months.
Is it a cool scar at least?
Yeah.
So you've been a seven rider for a pretty long time. What do you like about riding for that team?
I like it because I like their gear. I like their compression. And I don't know, it's sick gear.
Yeah. What do you think of the support guy? He's kind of a clown, huh?
No.
Huh?
And they literally live like 2 minutes from our office. He rides his race bike there sometimes during the week. At our office in Marietta.
At the KTM track up above, or?
Yeah, he lives like right behind that track.
Okay, yeah, yeah. So, so you get to ride Supercross on your home track with quite a few guys that are current professionals. Do you think that that's a advantage for you to get to watch and learn in your own backyard?
Yeah.
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 Right on. Well, hey man, good luck this weekend. I'm sure you got your sights on a couple titles, right? So let's hope that happens. I don't want to see any more unconscious burn incidents.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Hey, yeah. Thanks for watching Mini Major Daily presented by OGIO. We'll talk to you tomorrow.